what are the consequences, that is, what are the results of liquid pressure? That is, due to liquid pressure, what happens? Okay, these are the results. What are the effects of liquid pressure we are going to discuss? So first one, you have seen the sea or the oceans. Okay, water is there. Now, as we have already studied, that as depth increases, pressure increases. It means at the base of the sea or the ocean, maximum pressure will be there. As the depth increases, pressure increases. Okay, now you have seen the divers, they wear special kind of suits. Now, if they, without wearing any suits, if they dive, what happens? The pressure will increase. This pressure is tremendous at a very depth. So it may happen there, our bones may burst. It may crush our bones, not burst. It may crush our bones. It will, because huge pressure will be applied, and this pressure may crush our bones. So divers wear special kind of suits to withstand that high pressure. So first thing is clear?
Yes, sir.
So as the depth increases, pressure increases, and since at a very depth it's huge pressure, it may crush the bones. Therefore, divers must have to wear a special kind of suits designed so that they can withstand such high pressure and they can remain safe at the depth. Okay. Second one, you have seen the submarines. Submarines, they have the ability to go down deep down inside the ocean, and they can come up to the surface. So their main function is to go deep down so that they cannot be searched by the other, or they can do the surveillance or any spy work they can continue. So there, as we have already seen, as the depth increases, pressure increases. Therefore, the walls of the submarine must be so strong that it can withstand such high pressure. Therefore, it is made up of thick steel alloys, very thick steel alloys, sheets it is made up of, so that it can withstand high pressure. Second is clear. Third one, okay. Those fishes which live near the base, that is at depth they live. Okay, what kind of fishes they can be? See, since pressure will be high, therefore those fish must have high blood pressure, or their body pressure must be high so that they can withstand such high pressure. So as their blood pressure or their body pressure is high, now if we take them out, what will happen? There will be pressure difference between the surrounding and their blood pressure. So those fish may burst. They will burst because their blood pressure is so high that out they start to expand and they will burst. Is this clear? So these are the consequences of high blood pressure, of liquid pressure. This is clear. With this, we complete the liquid pressure. Okay. Let's do the checkpoint 3. A dash exerts a lateral pressure to lateral pressure liquid. A liquid exerts a lateral pressure to liquid. First one is liquid. Okay. Second, liquid pressure dash with the increase in depth below its free surface. It increases. Second one, increases. Third one, liquid pressure dash on the surface area on which it acts. Liquid pressure. It, liquid, listen again, liquid pressure dash on the surface area on which it acts. Surface area, does liquid pressure depend on surface area? It does not depend on liquid pressure, surface area. You have seen already liquid pressure formula, HDG, height, that is depth, no surface area. So liquid pressure does not depend. Third is, does not depend. It does not depend on surface area or which it acts. Okay. Answer these questions. Describe an activity show that a liquid exerts pressure. Liquid exerts pressure. Which activity you use? We have to tell them activity.
Activity 4.
Page number 52. To show that liquid pressure, liquid exerts pressure. That activity you have to show. Okay, tube we have taken, membrane we have attached to one side, and we filled water, membrane. expanded. Okay, that is bulge form, that one. Okay, name any two factors on which liquid pressure depends. Any two factors?
Sets on level and liquid pressure depends upon
density. Depends on
density of a liquid.
Density of a liquid and height of the liquid column above that point. Height of the liquid column. Okay, or depth of the depth of. Okay, so you can get it from page number 55. 53 as well, they are given, I think. Page number 53. Yes, sir. Yes. Mm-hmm. Page number 53. Liquid pressure depends upon density of the liquid. Pressure at a point inside the liquid increases with the depth of the free surface, depth from the free surface of the liquid. So it depends on density of the liquid. It depends on depth from the free surface of the liquid. Depth of, from the free surface of the liquid. These two points you can write. Okay. Is this clear? Yes. Yes. Okay. These two factors. Liquid.
Shape and size.
No. Does not depend on shape and size of the container. Liquid pressure does not depend. You can see as well. It depends on height, density, and gravitational acceleration. That is force due to gravity, you can say, for time being. This is acceleration due to gravity. Force due to gravity, you can say. This acceleration due to gravity depends on gravitational force. So, mainly you can say it depends on height and density. Only these two points it depends. That is depth from the free surface and density of the liquid. These two only it depends. Does not depend on shape and size of the container. Whatever shape, it doesn't matter. This you already seen.
If the liquid has more density, then the liquid will exert more pressure on the
structure. If density is more, then it will exert more pressure. Okay. For example, you take kerosene. Okay, olive oil. Let's take olive oil. And here we take mercury. Both are liquid. Okay. What is the density of the mercury? 13600 kg per meter cube. What is the density of olive oil? 900 kg per meter cube. Or water you take, that is 1000. Compare them, which will have more density at the same depth. If the depth is same, mercury will exert more pressure. P equal to hdg. Height is same, acceleration due to gravity is same, only the depth changes. Only the density changes. So as density changes, the liquid pressure changes. So the liquid which is having is more dense will exert more pressure at the same depth. Clear?
Yes. This is clear.
Okay. Okay, let's do the question answer. Then we'll start the pressure indices. Okay. Liquid pressure. So we have completed up to which question? Why are the tape edges? Why are it all symbols? Okay. Ninth question. We have to start with ninth. Show by a simple experiment that a liquid exerts lateral pressure too. Lateral pressure. So we dig three holes at different heights. Which was there? Page number 54. So what we did, we took a beaker, a metal can or a long glass jar having three holes at different heights. We have closed those holes. Or we we screwed the lids and then we filled the water, then we removed the lids. What happens? Water from the top hole falls near the base, whereas water from the bottom hole at the base, it will be more water rushing. Okay, this you are done?
Sir, it is on page number 53.
That was increasing with depth. Okay. Page number 53 to show liquid exerts lateral pressure. Okay. We have what have we discussed was that it increases with depth. Okay. That is this estimate you have to show. The hole is there and balloon is tight. Thank you. Page number 53. Activity 5. Page number 53. Activity 5. Okay. Does liquid pressure at a point depend on the shape and size of the container? Does liquid pressure? No, it does not depend. It does not depend on shape and size of the container. It depends only on depth, density of the liquid, and exhalation due to gravity. Only these points it depends. Know the liquid pressure does not depend. Know the liquid pressure at a point does not depend on the shape and size of the container. That will be the answer. 10th question is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's move to 11th. Explain that a liquid seeks its own level. Page number 55, activity 9. So we took different shapes of the container, all are connected at the base. Fill water in it, you will see that level is same in all the containers. So liquid seeks its own level. Activity 9. Okay. State two factors on which pressure at a point inside a liquid depends. We already done. Name. Page number 53. Liquid pressure depends upon the density of the liquid. Pressure at a point inside the liquid. Oh, it depends on depth from the free surface of the liquid. Okay. Same as we did in checkpoint 3. Yes, page number 55 also, and page number 58 also may be given. It's given somewhere there. Item density, okay. 13th point it is given, okay. 13th point. Page number 58, wrapping it up. WIAO. It's given there. Page 13th point, okay. This is clear? Okay. Let's move to next question. Describe an activity to show that air exerts a pressure. Okay, that's we will start now from there. Page number 56, that's fine, but you have to discuss that. Okay, so we have seen till now what we have seen. Liquid exert pressure. Similarly, air, or we can say gases exert pressure. Gases as well exert pressure. We do not feel that pressure. Why? Because there is a reason behind that. And we are going to discuss that reason as well. So we are starting with air pressure. Pressure exerted by air. So you have seen Earth. What it is enveloped by? Surrounding Earth, we are having an envelope of gases. And that envelope is called as? What it is called?
Atmosphere.
This is our Earth. And surround it, there's an envelope of gases. This is called as atmosphere. Atmosphere. So there's a kind of sphere around it, atmosphere. This is clear, atmosphere. So we are having atmosphere surrounding us. And this atmosphere, it exerts pressure. Okay, it exerts pressure. We do not feel, there's a reason behind that. We'll be discussing that after some time, okay? So what is the value of this atmosphere pressure at mean sea level? Mainly it is 10 raised to power 5 or 15. 5 pascals. 10 raised to power 5 pascals. This much is the pressure exerted by the atmosphere at the mean sea level. It is exerted at the mean sea level. This is nearly 1.013 into 10 raised to power 5. Pascals, but usually we take it that this is nearly equal to 1, so we usually say 10 raised to power 5 pascals. We usually say it is 10 raised to power 5 pascals. So atmosphere is exerting how much pressure? 10 raised to power 5 pascals at mean sea level. Okay, now how we can show that air exerts pressure? How we have to show that air exerts pressure? So what we do is for this. We take a thin can. A can made up of thin sheet we are taking. So it may be of 2 liters or 4 liters we are taking. Okay. So we have taken a can. And now it's having a hole. We poured some water inside it. It is filled with some water. Okay. And now on a gas burner, we started to heat it. As we heat it, what happens? Water will be converted into, it is going to convert into steam. Steam, or we can say, okay, let's say steam or vapor. Now, what earlier was contained? The can was having some water and gases were there. Air was there. Now, as steam is formed, this steam will expel the gases out. Gases are expelled. What remains inside now? Water and the steam. The can contains water and the steam. Now what we do? We screw the can. Okay, we screw the screw the mouth of the can tightly. Okay, we put the lid here. Now remove the burner and pour cold water over it. As we pour cold water over the can, what happens to the steam? Steam again, which condenses. Steam condenses back to water. Back to water. So now what will remain inside? Since air was already expelled out, steam condensed into water. Now there will be vacuum. There will be no air inside. And we see that it's get crushed. The tin can get crushed. Why it is being crushed? So see here. This was our can and it was closed. So no more air is inside, only the water and steam. As we poured cold water, the steam inside it get condensed and converted into water. Whatever space was remaining, it was vacuum. It was vacuum. And from all the sides, which is applying pressure, from all the sides, the air was applying pressure. But from inside, since there was no air inside, so no pressure was applied from inside, therefore it get crushed. Therefore it get crushed. So this proves that air exerts pressure. Air exerts pressure. This is clear. By this activity, we can show that air exerts pressure. This activity is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. There's one more activity to denote, okay, to verify atmospheric pressure. Okay, you have done it many times. I have seen many students doing it with their water bottles, using the cap. I don't know these days they are doing our school times. We have done many times in class. Okay, so see what, take a glass, fill it with water up to the brim. That is up to the top level you have filled. If you have filled it completely, now take a cardboard, place a cardboard over it. Now,
sir, your voice is not clear.
Sir, your voice is cutting in between.
Okay, is it fine now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, if again any disturbance is there, just let me know. I will reconnect this time. Okay, so hold the glass, put the cardboard over it. Now, hold it with your palm and invert it. Then remove your palm. What you see? The cardboard won't fall down. What is the reason behind that? If this is the glass and this is the cardboard, what is the reason behind that? It is filled with water completely and cardboard is not falling down. What is the reason? Okay, see here what is happening. Here, what's inside the glass? Water. It's a glass water, contained with water. So, it is applying pressure in which direction? This water. Downward direction it is applying. So, if we consider there is no air pressure, what will happen? Because of this pressure applied by the glass, this cardboard will fall down, water will fall down. Yes, but atmosphere is there. So, what atmosphere is doing? Atmosphere is as well pushing it. Atmosphere pushes from every side. For example, if this is the body, okay, here as well pressure is there by there. Here as well pressure is applied by there. In all the direction, the air is pushing it. It is pushing it. Okay, understood from all the directions. So here, this water pressure, it is balanced by the atmospheric pressure. This water pressure, it is balanced by the atmospheric pressure. Thus, this cardboard won't fall down. This cardboard won't fall down. Okay, this is clear. Okay, now we do something more. If you make a hole here, what happens now? See here, earlier when there was no hole, that is container. Since it's the glass, no air pressure is acting on water from this side. no more air, no air pressure is acting on the water since glass is there. So no more air pressure is transferred to the water contained in the glass. So only the pressure because of the height of the water column. That is the only pressure, HDG. The pressure at here will be HDG. And this pressure is balanced by the atmospheric pressure from downward. Therefore, it won't fall. But as I make a hole inside, as I make a hole here or anywhere I make, what happens as I make the hole? Now air will as well apply pressure. So see what is as air applies pressure. Now this air pressure plus pressure by the water becomes more than air pressure applied downward air pressure from the downward edge. Therefore, cardboard will fall down this time. Understood?
Excuse me, sir, I have a doubt.
Yes?
Sir, does this mean that the water, the liquid pressure and air pressure are equal? Because that is they are equal. Liquid pressure and gas atmospheric pressure is equal because then only it can...
Okay, one minute. Okay, see here, in this case, mainly, if it's this air pressure is more than the pressure applied by the water. This air pressure is more than the pressure applied by water. Okay. If you keep on increasing the water, there may be possibility at some point the pressure applied by the water will become equal to the pressure applied by the air pressure. So, for example, at this place, this air pressure is constant. At this height, air pressure is constant. But as I increase the height of the water column, the pressure applied by the water will keep on increasing or not? Will keep on increasing?
Yes.
It will keep on increasing. And there will be moment, that is, I'm keep on increasing this water column. There will be moment when both will become equal. And after that, if I increase the water column, water pressure will be more than the air pressure. It will fall. Understood? It's all about the difference between these two pressure. If it is more, it won't let it fall. When they become equal, it will just hold there. Okay. As it becomes more water pressure, it will fall down because resultant pressure, resultant force will be in this direction. Okay. So this experiment proves that air exerts pressure, that is atmospheric pressure is there. This is clear? Okay. Now the standard value of atmospheric pressure. What is the standard value of atmospheric pressure? So for sea, over the surface, we have mountains, we have oceans. Like this is the Earth surface. Okay. So pressure varies with height, but we have to take somewhere. What standard we should have taken? It will keep on varying the pressure. Standard pressure, how we take? At the mean sea levels. And at what latitude we have taken? 45 degrees. At 45 degree latitude, okay, 0 degree latitude, nearly about 45 degree latitude. We have taken at 45 degree latitude. At what temperature? 0 degree Celsius. So at zero, okay, we move to 45 degree latitude. Whatever pressure is there, whatever pressure is lifted by the air at the mean sea, at the sea level, that we consider as the standard atmospheric pressure, standard value of atmospheric pressure. And how it is being measured? We use barometer. To measure the atmospheric pressure, we use barometer. You have seen a glass, we take the tube, a glass test tube of height 1 meter we have taken. Okay, and filled it with mercury, completely filled. And a trough we take filled with mercury. We invert this glass tube inside it. Okay, now what is applied here? Air pressure. Air pressure will be applied from this side, and mercury we have here. What will the pressure here? It is because of the mercury column. Liquid pressure will be there here. Okay, it is out of syllabus. I'm just explaining to make you know. Now, atmospheric pressure is less than the pressure because of this mercury column. So what will happen? It will fall. So it falls up to certain height. For example, it has fallen here. Here, mercury level rises. Now, see from this point to this point, whatever this height of the mercury column is, that in terms of this height, we denote the atmospheric pressure. And for example, it comes out to be 0.76 mm of, that is 0.76 centimeters of 760 mm or 0.76 meter. So this height is 0.76. So in terms of this barometric height, in terms of this height, we are measuring the pressure. Okay, this is clear. Ritika, is it clear? This is clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Good. This is clear. This is out of syllabus. You study in 9th class this one. How to measure. Okay. But you have got this concept. In terms of barometric height, we are measuring the pressure. Okay. You got the height. Now, how to convert into pascals? HDG. HDG, height, density, and acceleration due to gravity. So, how to convert into pascals? Height, how much? In terms of barometric height, we have calculated 0.76. Density 13600. And acceleration due to gravity is how much? 9.8 meter per second square. Okay. And you calculate, it comes out to be 1.013 into 10 raised to power 5 pascals, or equivalent to 10 raised to power 5 pascals, we usually say. This is clear. So we have measured in terms of barometric height. Now see here, whatever pressure is applied by this barometric height, that is by the mercury column, that will be equal to the atmospheric pressure. Because this height stops where atmospheric pressure becomes equal to the height of the pressure applied by the mercury column. Now calculate the pressure applied by the mercury column. 0.76 into density into acceleration due to gravity, and you get. So we are going to discuss it in detail in higher classes. This is clear. Have you understood? Okay. Now,
yes, sir.
How that? Yes. Anyone have doubt? Ritika, you can switch off the video. Anyone have doubt in this? Okay. Now, what factors affects the atmospheric pressure? What factors? What factors? Okay. If this is the surface, as you go up on the mountains, what happens? Air pressure increases or decreases? It decreases. So at sea level, it is more. As you move up the altitudes, up the mountains, air pressure decreases. See here, this is the atmosphere, this is the height. More the height, more the pressure. Less the height, less the pressure. HDG, same formula is there. So less the height, less the pressure. At here, this much pressure is applied because of this much air. At here, only this much air, this much air, this much air. Okay, so see here, I tell you something. If you are a person, okay, this is you. This is we all here. Okay, now atmospheric pressure, how much is the pressure? It is like elephant is on our head. Okay. It's like an elephant is on our head. An elephant is sitting on our head. Atmospheric pressure value is how much? It is like we are carrying an elephant always on it, but we do not feel it. Why? There's a reason.
Blood pressure.
Because our blood pressure is slightly more than the atmospheric pressure. Yes, you have seen somewhere, anytime when a small cut happens, what happens? Blood comes out. Yes or no? That is, what is the reason? Because atmospheric pressure is less than blood pressure. Blood pressure is more, therefore blood comes out. If it would have been reverse, what would happen? If you were to cut, a small cut had happened, air would have entered inside. Yes, if blood pressure had been less, atmospheric pressure more, then if cut is there, blood won't come out, but air would have entered inside. Reverse would have happened. This is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Then, second point is, in calm weather during winter season, atmospheric pressure in place is somewhat more. Okay. And on a stormy summer day, atmospheric pressure is less. So, see, it's winter, it's cold. density of air is more in winter. It's cold, density of air is more, so more air pressure. And in summer, density of air is less because heat is there, it gets air spends, less pressure is there. It's stormy, carrying the winds here and there. Okay, this is clear. Now, effects of atmosphere pressure. What are the effects of atmosphere pressure? You have seen the liquid, you have seen the syringe. Syringe you have seen, injection we call.
Yes.
Okay, so to fill the liquid in the syringe, what we do? This is the plunger. We pull the plunger. As you pull the plunger, what happens? As you are pulling the plunger, there is a vacuum created inside. Here pressure will be less as compared to outside pressure. Air pressure will be, here the pressure will be less as compared to outside pressure. To equalize it, what happens? The liquid enters. If it is in the inside the liquid enters. Okay? Get filled in the syringe. This is clear. Second, how we fill the ink in fountain pen. Okay, fountain pen you have seen on the back.
Yes, it's like this.
Okay, you press it first. You press it first. Air is expelled. Now, the nib is inserted in the liquid, in the ink, and you release that one hook is given here. Release that. As it releases, what happens? Air pressure decreases here. Air pressure is more. Therefore, this liquid enters and gets filled. Okay. Okay, rest we'll discuss tomorrow then. Okay. Okay. So we end the class here. Tomorrow we'll discuss rest.
Thank you.
And then question answers. Do complete the question answers in your notebook. Okay. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Excuse me, sir.
Thank you, sir.